This is part four of the Fraternitas Saturni. This part is about the magical work of the Fraternitas Saturni. The sexual mysticism of the Fraternitas Saturni is called the Yoga of the Dark Light. The Yoga of the Dark Light, according to Dr. Stephen Flowers, is, quote, the practice of the union through sex magical techniques with the fleshy embodiment of one's own opposite self. Here, the dark light is interpreted as the Saturnian Luciferian light, as incarnate in the sexual partner, with whom ritual coitus or other practices are performed. The dark light can also be equated with the magical power of sexuality and of the orgasm, end quote. The doctrines regarding Saturnian sex magic are similar to those of another occult organization, the Ordo Templi Orientis, or OTO. However, the sexual magic practiced by the members of the Fraternitas Saturni are unique in many ways because the founder, Gregor A. Gregorius, incorporated ideas taken from astrological and Gnostic concepts as well as more modern ideas. There are 33 degrees in the order of the Fraternitas Saturni. Stephen Flowers notes that, for the most part, sex magical practices are part of the work of the 18th degree, which is called the Pentalphic degree. When the initiate pursues the study pertinent to this degree, he or she delves deeply into a study of the sexual magic and mysticism as it is practiced in the OTO system, because the FS was heavily influenced by OTO. Gregor A. Gregorius, the founder of the Fraternitas Saturni, accepted the OTO concept that sexuality is the key to understanding cosmogony. In other words, the natural laws of sexuality were a mirror of cosmic processes. There are a variety of sex magic practices that are utilized by members of the Fraternitas Saturni. The most traditional of these is called the 5M rite. This is based on Hindu Tantra practice. It is also called the Sacrament of the Pentagram. The purpose of this ritual is to create a living, mental or astral image, also called a psychogone. This is achieved by concentrating and directing sexual energies. The magician or magicians give the psychogone life by doing this act of concentrating and directing these energies. The psychogone is believed to have a magically created soul or psyche, but it acts only in accordance with the will of the creators and has no will of its own. The 5M rite is performed by male and female magicians that are erotically bound together. Before beginning the rite, the participants must abstain from sex. Meditation is also part of the pre-ritual. The five stages of the ritual are as follows. 1. Preparation of the temple room. 2. Entry of the pair into the temple room. The magus or male magician sits on a low stool that is situated in the middle of a circle in the room. The female medium crouches between his outspread legs. 3. Charging. A parchment is laid on the floor between the two participants. It is covered with the sigils of the psychogone that is to be evoked. 4. The working stage. And 5. The rite of Maituna, or the act of ritual coitus, which is carried out according to certain specifications. The female lowers herself onto the erect penis of the male, and when the act is completed, the female stands and allows the sperm and the now magically charged sexual fluids to drip onto the parchment. The parchment will now be used to create the psychogonic entity. The entity is directed by the magician. The goal of all of this is to create a living entity that will do the bidding of the magician. The manifestation of these cosmic processes is the physical sexual organs of humans. The phallus represents the divine willpower of imagination. In sexual magic, the power to form mental images is very important. The female sex organs symbolize the manifestation of expansive chaos, the matri, in which reality takes shape. By willfully visualizing images and projecting them consciously into the chaotic matrix, the manifestation of all realities is made possible. The sexual magic of the Fraternitas Saturni encompasses various techniques, but also significant is the sexual cosmology that is part of the FS doctrine. The techniques and cosmology are taken in part from tantric systems and Gnostic sexual cosmologies, respectively. From tantrism comes the concept about the chakra system in the human body. From Gnosticism came the theory of an ultimate god that manifested from the Godhead and has three parts to it. These are the mind, the Greek word nous, thought, the Greek word ennoia, and reason, the Greek word logos. From this ultimate god, which is seen as masculine, came the first aeon, seen as his mirror image. The aeon is called either Barbello or Sophia, which means wisdom, which is the feminine aspect of the father god, but is herself androgynous. Sophia is the mother of the Demiurge, and Gnostics believe she implanted the divine spark in humans. The Gnostics believed Sophia was the first entity to fall. They explain that the fall was the result of Sophia's excessive craving for knowledge. Of course, we see this in a correspondence between the esoteric Eden and the myth with Lilith and Eve. Even though the Saturnine system shows the influence of Gnostic thought, we must remember that Saturnosis is a unique Gnostic teaching. The founder of the Fraternitas Saturni taught that the negatively polarized manifestations of Saturnian and lunar forces were on Earth incarnated into the forms of women. He taught that women are the representatives or agents of the Luciferian principle. Women are seen to correspond to the planet Venus, while men correspond to the planet Mars. Men are also the manifestation of the solar and Jupiterian forces and are supposed to utilize sexual magic to free themselves from the female demonium or evil spirit. Stephen Flowers notes that historically there were a lack of women initiates in the Fraternitas Saturni. He states that the reason for this is that it takes a very special woman to be able to accept this viewpoint and agree to be part of the initiatory process. The role of the female in Fraternitas Saturni sexual magic is different from that of other groups that practice magical work. In the Fraternitas Saturni, the female is expected to be aware of and cooperate with the work, not to be just a pure medium, as is in the case in other groups that practice sexual magic. Sexual magic is not the only magical work performed by the adherents of the Saturnine path. The magical work of the Fraternitas Saturni takes place in other ways as well. One of these is a curriculum of private magical training that's carried out in solitude and follows the progression of the degree system of the order. Saturnian magic rituals make use of aspects adopted from Freemasonic rituals. The order also practices a number of sacramental rites. It places an emphasis on the Luciferian principle. In addition, it makes use of electrical technology in a magical framework. Stephen Flowers describes these rituals in his book and states that the reason we know about these, even though they were not meant for public consumption, is because we now have access to old internal documents of the order. The initiation and transformation of the initiates of the order is done through magic training and ritual initiation. The student must develop the prized Saturnian characteristics of seriousness, concentration, critical thinking, intuition, and knowledge. A focus is especially placed upon intellectual pursuits. The initiate must become master of both the dark and white lights in order to command the daemons of the nether regions as well as the angels of the mental realm. The magical training of the initiate begins with intensive study of the internal literature of the Fraternitas Saturni. The study proceeds in order according to the grade the initiate is trying to attain. An extremely important part of the magical training is the magical training of the chela or the initiate. This is a Sanskrit word that means student of a master. The transformation of initiates is done through magical training and ritual initiation. Saturnosis is focused upon understanding the shadow side of the light, the night side of being. This is the Klipotic realm of the Kabbalists. It is important to note, however, that while the initiate is engaged with the shadow side of the light, it is stressed that the highest ethical standards must be invoked while dealing with these forces. During the training, the initiate carries out a repolarization of himself. This is akin to the alchemical process of synthesizing the Saturnian lead with the solar gold, or in other words, bringing the two poles of extreme together. This is in recognition of the significance of both the dark side and the light side. Dr. Flowers describes this in astrological terms as, the resting lion is driven to the Saturnian goat, from where it can descend to rule in an enlightened condition in the realm of the earth. The magical training of the order includes the disciplining of the will through exercises in visualization, auto-suggestion, contemplation, and meditation. The chakras must also be awakened, and breathing techniques are utilized for this purpose. Dream analysis is another aspect of training. The initiate is encouraged to develop the physical body as well and to cultivate a love of nature in general. Once all these have been developed to a certain level, the initiate begins work on magical experiments geared toward influencing the environment. The important work of sexual magic is begun, and the initiate must learn to master sexual drives and spiritualize sexual experiences. Adherents of the Fraternitas Saturni believe one of the aims of sexual magic is to heal the relations between the sexes in this aeon. Auto-hypnosis is used by the initiate to enter trance states and to carry out past life regression therapies in order to prove the doctrine of reincarnation. The final triumph for the initiate is when the guardian of the threshold opens the gate into the trans-Saturnian spheres. This is said to take place at the end of the initiate's incarnation, where he or she reaches the abyss. Here, the decision is made to either prepare for the next incarnation or lifetime in order to continue to do Saturn's work or to move on to a higher level. The important concept that is stressed, however, is that whatever decision the initiate makes at that point, it is made purely out of free will. At this stage of initiation, then, the initiate has achieved power over life and death. Thus, the exalted state of solitary freedom is realized. And so, Gregorius's founding belief in the power of Saturn, in discovering that the darkness contains light, continues to impact lives today. He said, when the ego has reached the dark gate of Saturn in its spiritual development, it is considered ripe to cross the threshold to higher realizations lying in the spheres behind it. Then, Saturnus, the guardian of the threshold, the lord of karma, lowers the torch of death. So the ultimate aim of the process of initiation is for the initiate to move beyond good and evil and attain the ultimate power of an independent and truly real entity to become his or her own God.